going to discuss about the paraphrasing and the second class of the paraphrasing. Okay, here we are going to we discussed in the first class about the definitions and methods and how to paraphrase. These three topics are completed in the first class. Now we are going to take the second class. In the second class, I am going to tell you about a few tips of effective paraphrasing. Okay, tips to how to write paraphrasing clearly and correct way to paraphrase. Okay, what is the correct way? What are the steps involved in the correct way? Okay, what are the tips involved in the paraphrasing? And what are the do's and do nots of paraphrasing? What will we do and we don't do while writing a paraphrasing? Today we are going to discuss. Okay, now the first topic is a few tips of effective paraphrasing. How paraphrasing will be effective? How can we do paraphrase effectively? There are some tips to follow. Here are the tips. Okay, I am going to tell you the tips now. A few tips to effective paraphrasing. First tip. Okay, in the few tips, I am discussing the first one. Read the original text several times. Read the original text several times. As many as possible, you have to read the text thoroughly. For which paragraph or for which story we are going to paraphrase, we have to read that paraphrase many times, as many as possible. Okay, as many times as possible. You have to read the paragraph or a story several times. Then you will get that clear idea about that story or paragraph. Okay, read the original text. What is original text here? What is called original text means the para which we are going to do paraphrase is called original text. Okay, it is the author's story or narrator's any paragraph or whatever it may be. The original means the idea of the author. The idea of author we have to read thoroughly, read several times. Why we have to read several times means to get the full meaning, of the paragraph. Then only we can able to do paraphrase in our own words. Okay, if you got the total idea of the para means, you can easily translate the paragraph in your own words. So our paraphrasing will be easy. That's why read the original text several times till you understand the meaning very clearly. Very clearly. If you read one time means you would get some points into your mind. If you read the second time means then you will get the some extra information from that paragraph. Like that, for every time we will improve the information from the paragraph. We will improve the clear idea about that. We will maintain some clarity by reading several times. Okay, this is the first tip. You have to read the original text several times till you understand the meaning very clearly. Up to when you have to read? Up to you get the very clear idea, very clear meaning of that paragraph. Up to then you have to read the original text several times. This is the first tip. If you read it very well means you can paraphrase the topic easily. Okay, that is the first one you have to note. And the second one, what is the second tip? Without looking at the original source, original story or paragraph, note down in points whatever you have understood from the text. You already read the text several times, no? From that text, without looking the text, you have to note down what you understood by reading several times. Okay, you have to read several times the first tip. Okay, but this is the first step, right? From that first step, you have to continue the second step also. What you have to do means, without looking the source, note down the points, whatever you have understood by reading. Okay, this is the second step. First step, you have to read several times until you get the clear clarity on that paragraph. Okay, on the text. Next, second point is, without looking at the text, original text, you have to note down some points what you your own words. Means first you write down, after that you are note down some important points for the paragraph. Third one is you have to rewrite the material using your own words. Rewrite the material by not looking into the original text. You have to write on your own. Don't copy from the original text. It is not paraphrasing. It will get plagiarism. Already I discussed you. Plagiarism. Okay. From the third point, what we learn? We have to rewrite the material using our own words. Okay. We have to write on our own. But without changing the meaning. Own words means you write another topic words or another, it is not correct. You have to maintain the meaning also while you are writing in your own words. You have to maintain the same meaning in the text. You don't change the meaning, but without changing the meaning, you are not supposed to change the meaning. You have to give the reader the same meaning from the text, but you can change your words also, or phrases or sentences, whatever it may be, but it have to convey the same meaning in the text, original text. Okay, meaning must be maintained samely. Okay, here is the third one. And now fourth tip of the affective paragraph. Already we learned the three tips. First tip is read the paragraph several times until we have to understand, we have to get the clear idea about that. And second one is without looking at the source, note down the points, whatever you understood from the reading, okay, from the text. What you learned from the text, you have to note down the points. That is the second one. Third one, by not looking, by not changing the meaning, you have to rewrite the text. Okay, rewrite the material or text.